North Korea is building a nightmare the world isn't ready for. Across the world, machines are replacing humans in everything from factory floors to medicine. But in Pyongyang, they're taking it one step further. What happens when killer drones and even nuclear bombs are placed under AI control? Could a single bug trigger the end of the world? On today's episode of the Infographic Show, we'll uncover why North Korea is handing over weapons of mass destruction to AI. The world has been holding its breath. The threat of World War III has been looming on the horizon, but no one has pressed the button. Then, without a warning, a flurry of activity erupts at North Korea's nuclear sites. Missile silos activate, warheads arm, and launches look only minutes away. In Washington, London, and Paris, nuclear command centers are on high alert. Nuclear-armed bombers take to the sky, and submarines to the seas. In his deep underground bunker just outside Pyongyang, North Korea's Supreme Leader Kim Jong Un stares at his cell phone in a panic. He has incoming calls from Russian President Vladimir Putin, Chinese President Xi Jinping, French President Emmanuel Macron, the Pentagon, and more. Panic grips him as the eyes of the world lock on his every move. Nuclear annihilation is only moments away, and there is nothing that he can do. The machines have taken over, and he is utterly helpless. It sounds like the plot of an intense Hollywood sci-fi thriller, but the odds of a scenario like this actually unfolding have grown tremendously. And that's because Kim has ordered the North Korean military to deeply integrate AI into all spheres of operations, including its nuclear forces. For years, some of the loudest voices in tech have warned that giving AI too much control over human affairs could prove catastrophic. Elon Musk, for example, has long warned that unless humanity can tame the technology, it may eventually destroy us. Yet despite these warnings, AI has grown at an exponential rate. Even Musk himself has fueled that growth with projects like his Grok chatbot and AI-powered ventures. AI is rapidly finding its way into military systems worldwide. It's now become an arms race, with nations competing to gain an edge through automation and machine learning. In 2023, the Atlantic Council warned that modern militaries must embrace human-machine learning, HMT, or risk conceding military edge to competitors, effectively leveraging AI and autonomy. And there are some very good reasons why the world's militaries are embracing the tech. AI and HMT have the potential to transform the battlefield by enhancing decision-making, extending precision strike capabilities, and increasing the reach of human operators. These technologies promise not only greater lethality, but also the ability to minimize casualties. Beyond combat, it could also streamline logistics, sustainment, and administrative functions. Military personnel would be freed up, allowing them to concentrate on higher-value mission tasks. And for now, the US holds a commanding lead in terms of AI development, although China is steadily closing the gap. Initially, the US tested the waters with AI applications like Palantir's Project Maven, which taught computers to recognize targets through imagery. Since then, the project has evolved, incorporating tools that can predict equipment failures and even guide military planning. And now, these systems are no longer confined to testing. They're being used in Ukraine, where they have sharpened surveillance and increased accuracy for drone strikes. By 2025, the Department of Defense was investing more heavily in artificial intelligence than ever before. Major contracts worth up to $200 million each went to firms such as Anthropic, Google, OpenAI, and xAI to push the development of next-generation frontier models. Alongside that, the DoD committed $100 million to pilot new generative AI applications over a two-year period. The US Army has already taken the lead, rolling out a generative AI platform called Ask Sage across its cloud network. Designed to streamline coding and acquisition, the system has been hailed as a success. It allegedly shows developers how to work 35 times faster, but AI is also being integrated into core combat systems and decision-making processes. The US Air Force has already put AI into action, using it in live operations to automate target recognition. The Navy, meanwhile, is testing unmanned vessels guided by AI to expand its surveillance and reconnaissance networks at sea. Beyond these efforts, the Pentagon is pushing forward with agent-based AI designed to support battlefield planning. A $130.1 billion AI research and development budget tells you exactly how important AI and other advanced technologies are to the DoD's current and future projects. Meanwhile, across the Pacific, there's a very similar process underway in China. China's also moving to quickly weave AI into its military under a strategy it calls intelligentization. They aim to modernize the People's Liberation Army, or PLA, by embedding AI into combat, command, and multi-domain operations. Much like the US, the PLA is deploying AI for intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance, using it to analyze satellite imagery and massive streams of battlefield data. The quality of the PLA's AI systems is likely to be pretty high. Reports indicate that it has developed its own advanced models through firms such as DeepSeek and Jipu AI. At the same time, it has quietly purchased models from foreign companies like Meta and OpenAI. China is also relentlessly developing unmanned or autonomous systems, including swarming drones and unmanned underwater vehicles, or UUVs. These would be critical for anti-submarine warfare and operations in the Indo-Pacific theater. The PLA is also invested into AI for predictive maintenance, logistics, and even wargaming simulations to improve training exercises. There also are claims that the PLA is experimenting with AI for social media manipulation and deepfake generation. Beijing's prepared to use AI not just for the battlefield, but also as a weapon of propaganda and misinformation. But these rapid advances are not limited to the US and China. Similar effects are unfolding across the globe, in Russia, India, Turkey, Australia, the United Kingdom, and beyond. The advantages presented by AI speak for themselves: higher quality information, quicker decision-making, more accurate targeting, and cost efficiencies. But the deeper AI is integrated into weapon systems, the higher the risk of error, escalation, and abuse. Still, these dangers have not deterred nations around the world from pursuing military AI programs of their own, including North Korea. According to a report in the Daily NK, on August 2nd, the General Staff Department, or GSD, of the Korean People's Army issued an official order to all branches of the KPA through encrypted wireless networks. They were instructed to, quote, make plans to build AI-based manned and unmanned multipurpose combat systems ahead of the Ninth Party Congress, which is scheduled for 2026. The General Staff Department ordered all branches, the Army, Navy, Air Force, Special Operations Forces, and Strategic Force, to draft AI-driven modernization plans by the end of September. After review in October, selected elements would be tested in winter training. The approved projects would be rolled out in December, either through existing units or newly formed trial formations. Each branch received specific directives. The Army was tasked with introducing AI command systems for infantry, mechanized, and artillery forces. The Navy was told to design new joint exercises covering harbor defense, EMP response, nuclear counterattacks, minesweeping, and submersible missions. The Air Force was ordered to prepare tactical drills with mixed manned and unmanned formations. Meanwhile, Special Operations Forces were directed to craft irregular warfare plans that included drone assassinations, demolitions, infiltrations, and amphibious terrorism. The idea of AI-powered North Korean drones stalking civilians or carrying out assassinations is terrifying. But the US, China, and many others have already taken similar steps. In many ways, Kim is simply playing catch-up. But North Korea's integration of AI into its conventional forces isn't the real problem. Rather, Kim plans to enable his nuclear program, and that is causing huge red flags from Washington to Beijing. The Korean People's Army, or KPA Strategic Force, which combines North Korea's nuclear arsenal, has been tasked with a four-stage leap strategy. The goal is to integrate AI systems to manage, operate, and command nuclear weapons, as well as to launch nuclear counterattacks. North Korean-trained AI overseeing the world's second most secretive nuclear stockpile. What could possibly go wrong? Whether these plans will materialize on schedule or at all remains to be seen, but they are hardly Kim's first ventures into AI. In fact, North Korea's efforts began well before he took power, with the creation of the Yongbyul AI program in 1998, initially designed to play the game Go. Through the early 2000s, most of the country's AI projects had civilian aims, from forecasting air pollution and preparing for droughts to monitoring hydro turbine vibrations. More recently, Pyongyang is believed to have applied AI during the COVID-19 pandemic to model mask usage and identify key symptoms of the virus. However, starting from around 2019, Kim's interest in AI began to take on a decidedly more militaristic focus. In late March, North Korea's state-run KCNA reported that Kim personally oversaw tests of various kinds of reconnaissance and attack drones developed at the country's unmanned aerial technology complex. The new reconnaissance models were said to feature artificial intelligence capable of tracking strategic targets and enemy troop movements on land and at sea. The attack drones, meanwhile, were described as intended for various tactical missions. Around the same time, Daily NK reported that the General Staff Department had created a new Electronic Warfare and AI Operation Command. It was tasked with strengthening electronic weapons and boosting command capacity through AI. That follows the announcement in March of the establishment of Research Center 227. This unit is tasked with researching and developing international cyber hacking technologies incorporating AI. In other words, it is North Korea's AI-enhanced cyber warfare unit. North Korea's cyber warfare program, led by squads like the infamous Lazarus Group, has long been both a threat and a vital revenue stream for the Hermit Nation. Between 2018 and 2023, its hackers stole an estimated $1.2 billion in cryptocurrency and other digital assets, and that was before the arrival of generative AI. By October of 2023, the U.S. publicly acknowledged that Pyongyang was using AI in cyber warfare. Then Deputy National Security Advisor Ann Nuremberger warned that North Korea, along with other states, was using AI models to speed up malicious software development and identify vulnerable systems. Research Center 227 is reportedly dedicated to using AI to advance offensive hacking, developing tools to steal information and assets, disrupt networks, and neutralize security systems. Its missions include AI-driven information theft, financial hacking, and automated programs for large-scale data collection and analysis. Given the success of Ukraine's asymmetric warfare against Russia, in no small part enabled by AI, these developments are a serious concern. North Korea's cyber warfare capabilities are already a thorn in Western sides, not to mention the hundreds of corporations and businesses they have attacked and held for ransom. The rapid decision-making and the real-time adaptation by AI will make North Korean cyber attacks more difficult to counter. As a result, AI could become one of North Korea's key asymmetric weapons, allowing it to disrupt adversaries at a fraction of the cost of traditional military forces. But if swarms of AI-generated deepfake North Korean scam bots terrorizing the internet wasn't frightening enough, the prospect of advanced AI controlling North Korea's nuclear forces is even more alarming. Most of the information about North Korea's nuclear arsenal sits on a sliding scale between somewhat speculative and completely unknown. Ever since the nation withdrew from the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty in 2006, its nuclear program has been shrouded in secrecy. As of 2024, the country is estimated to possess an arsenal of roughly 50 nuclear weapons, with sufficient fissile material to produce 6 to 7 additional weapons per year. Some estimates suggest North Korea could have enough material for up to 90 nuclear warheads, based on the ongoing production of highly enriched uranium and plutonium. North Korea also has a range of nuclear-capable short, medium, and intercontinental ballistic missiles, and a selection of both strategic and tactical nuclear warheads to attach to them. Most of the delivery systems are land-based, although Kim's submarine-launched missile capabilities are coming in leaps and bounds. North Korea fields 3 types of land-based medium-range ballistic missiles, the Hwasong-7, Hwasong-9, and Pukuksong-2, or KN-15. Of these, the KN-15 is the most concerning. At 31 feet long and fired from a tracked vehicle, it is mobile, difficult to target before launch, and capable of striking anywhere on the Korean peninsula. Tokyo, Taipei, and much of the northern Pacific are also within its range. Beyond that, North Korea operates 3 intercontinental ballistic missiles, the Hwasong-15, Hwasong-17, and Hwasong-18, capable of reaching most, if not all, of the continental United States. The Hwasong-18, unveiled in early 2023, is the most advanced. At roughly 82 feet in length and weighing up to 60 tons, it's launched from a 9-axle transporter, and it may be capable of carrying multiple independently targeted re-entry vehicles, or MIRVs, allowing a single missile to deliver multiple warheads against different targets. Crucially, North Korea claims that the missile's operational range could reach 9,300 miles, depending on payload weight. If that's true, that covers the entirety of the continental U.S., easily putting cities like Los Angeles and New York City within striking distance. But even if most of the U.S. is actually beyond the range of North Korea's ICBMs, it's possible that submarines could get close enough to launch nuclear strikes. A North Korean nuclear strike against the U.S., Japan, or South Korea would almost certainly trigger a devastating American response, one that could erase the country and much of its population from the map. That reality makes it difficult to imagine any North Korean leader, even one as unpredictable as Kim, pressing the button. But with AI, can we be so sure? Already, most of North Korea's nuclear forces are housed in the so-called missile belt of bases around the peninsula. While many have been identified, the recent CSIS report estimates that there are still 15 to 20 hidden bases. Precious little is known about the state of North Korea's nuclear weapons and material, where they're stored, and how well they're looked after. Given the extreme secrecy around the nuclear program, the potential for an accidental nuclear disaster is already the highest among known nuclear powers. Now, add AI to the mix. Linking all those bases into an AI-coordinated system and into the command, control, and launch structures will be anything but simple, and the potential for catastrophe is enormous. On its simplest level, AI-controlled reconnaissance drones might decide to cross into the South's airspace intentionally. This would trigger a major escalation of tensions and bring the peninsula to the brink of full-scale war. Giving AI control over targeting and firing might easily lead to an accidental launch. There's also the risk that AI might not function properly during battle, with limited capability to switch back to manual operations, leading to potentially devastating consequences. But this is a risk that affects all nations currently scrambling not to get left behind in the AI arms race, not just North Korea. The bottom line is that for all the efficiency and strategic advances they deliver, AI and autonomous systems also pose one of the biggest existential threats to humanity, especially when AI is applied to nuclear weapons programs. In the wrong hands and without robust human oversight, they have the potential to trigger global conflict before anyone realizes what's happening. It's a terrifying thought that gets ever more real with each passing day. If giving AI control over nukes sounds terrifying, imagine what happens if one is actually launched. See the chain of events in What If North Korea Launched a Nuclear Bomb Minute by Minute, or click on this video instead.